On this Thanksgiving weekend, we have a story from Minnesota's Twin Cities PBS station about finding family. This past summer, Kaomi Lee shared her personal story. Like many of the more than 200,000 adopted Koreans around the world, Lee was adopted as a small child, brought to a new country, and raised by parents of a different race. Lee still does not know her birth parents, but a decision to share her results from a DNA test brought a surprising discovery.
With most of the state in drought conditions and half the state in severe drought.
As Almanac's Greater Minnesota reporter, I usually report on stories from around the state. This story is a little different.
It's actually when I became a citizen.
50 years ago, I was adopted as an infant from South Korea and sent to a Lutheran pastor and his wife in rural Minnesota. I thought I left Korea with just a name, a presumed birth date, and the clothes on my back, with no hope of finding family. Little did I know, I also had something very powerful, my DNA. And I'm not alone.
Well, Ben has spoken to his half-brother, Jeff, but they've never met face-to-face until now. Ben, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Jeff, come on out.
Yeah!
Commercial DNA tests have been connecting relatives to each other for the past 15 years. For Korean adoptees who often can't access records or birth identities, the tests have been a game changer.
Right now, we have over 12 million customers, and about 80% of those customers have found a third cousin or closer. I think a lot of this information is really invaluable for everyone, but specifically for adoptees, especially because typically, adoptees don't have family history, whether it's their ancestry or health. And actually, certain ancestries can put you at a higher risk of developing certain diseases. And so we've heard from so many customers, it's impacted their lives tremendously.
I took 23andMe's DNA test 5 years ago. I shared the results in some other databases. And then this spring, I got a message. Someone in Denmark thought they were my half-sister or niece. And like me, she was also a Korean adoptee.
You know, I think, oh, we just take a day at a time.
We did more tests. All signs pointed to half-sisters. But after Denmark opened to visitors, I decided to fly and meet Lisa Beck. But I was still nervous. How would it feel to meet a previously unknown biological sibling for the first time? Would we get along? Would we have anything to talk about? Would meeting her help me better understand myself?
Oh.
Then the moment happened.
I'm tearing up.
Oh, it's nice to see you. Finally.
Did you wait a long time?
Yeah, I'm filming and I'm just so nervous.
Nice to see you.
So nice to see you.
We got a chance to sit down together face to face. I learned that Lisa decided to do a DNA test on a whim.
Early morning, I lay in my bed and I was very tired and I just took my phone out and then, oh, what? I have a sister. I was so confused and excited at the same time. Yeah.
What was going through your mind when you saw me?
I was amazed. I was surprised because I can see the similarities, but I can't put a finger on it, you know, exactly what it is. But I can see we look like, you know, nose, mouth, cheeks, mm-hmm, and so on. So I can see we...
Maybe the eyes.
Yeah. So I can see we look similar.
Lisa and I don't know who our birth parents are. Finding each other through DNA feels like beating all odds. Our story was even featured on national Danish TV.
We did it.
We also met with Korean adoptees in Denmark. Like Minnesota, there are thousands here. Lisa and I had fun getting to know each other during the short visit. But instead of answering questions, meeting Lisa created more.
Now that I know about you, it just makes me start to, you know, go down the rabbit hole of who was our father? Yeah. What, is he still alive? Yeah. Do we have other siblings out there? I'm also very aware that many adoptees do not get this opportunity. And that helps me to know how special it is that we did find each other.